Here's an article from Environmental Research, a peer-reviewed journal titled Age-stratified Infection Fatality Rate of COVID-19 in the Non-Elderly Population, released on 1st of January 2023. The study aimed to accurately estimate the fatality rate of COVID-19 among non-elderly populations in the absence of vaccination or prior infection. The researchers point out that non-elderly people represent the vast majority of the global population, with 94% of the global population being younger than 70 years old, 91% being younger than 65 years old, and 86% being younger than 60 years old, noting that infection fatality rate is defined as the proportion of deceased among those infected. The researchers sourced information from 38 countries with regards to pre-vaccination data, while they were able to source age-stratified death data from 29 countries. I'll just jump straight to their findings, although feel free to download the article if you wish to examine it further. For 0 to 19-year-olds, the median infection fatality rate, the IFR, was 0.0003%. That means for every 1 million children who officially caught COVID, 3 of them on average died from COVID, according to the officially released statistics. For comparison, according to the Australian Journal of General Practice from 2020, influenza had a case fatality rate of 0.0031 to 0.03% in the paediatric population, with that rising to 0.14 to 0.45% for influenza pneumonia. COVID has proven to be significantly milder in young people, although it should be noted that this flu data is for under fives, which are typically more affected by flu than older children. Anyway, for 20 to 29-year-olds, the median IFR was 0.002%, or 2 in 100,000. For 30 to 39-year-olds, 0.011%, or about 1 in 10,000. For 40 to 49-year-olds, 0.035%, or 3.5 in 10,000. For 50 to 59-year-olds, 0.123%, or about 1 in 1,000. And for 60 to 69-year-olds, 0.506%, or about 5 in every 1,000 people succumbed to their illness. Noting that this means that for people in their 60s who caught COVID, 99.494% survived. The researchers are just trying to point out that for the large majority of the world's population, COVID had quite low fatality rates. The study also points out that at the global level, pre-vaccination IFR may have been as low as 0.03% and 0.07% for 0 to 59 and 0 to 69-year-old people, respectively, noting that the original strain of the virus was potentially more lethal than it is today. But despite this, people under 70 still had a relatively low fatality rate as shown by the data. I suppose the key takeaway from this study is that the current analysis suggests a much lower pre-vaccination fatality rate in non-elderly populations than previously suggested. You don't have to go back very far to find articles that criticised such suggestions. Here's an article from Forbes from 21st of April 2020. Scientists widely criticise studies that claim coronavirus death rate could be far lower than believed. Anyway, that's the data. I'll leave a link to this study in the description below.